Good day, everybody. Today's vlog is about our doggy Tipper, my Australian cattle dog. And I'd like to show you how a day with our doggy is. We walk, we give her food, she will sleep, and we will share that with you. Stay tuned. Yeah. My doggy is 14 and a half years old, so walking stairs, downstairs is something she cannot do anymore. So I have to carry her, 27 kilograms. And when we go down the stairs, it's pickup time.
Go on.
Why she not ask me to clean the door, the window? Why she ask to ask people? Maybe you ask, why you not ask me to clean the window?
So, hey, oh, you like it. Hey, yeah, go, let's go, let's go. Well, you can see how old she is. She's born in February 2006. And yeah, that means she's 14 years old, 14 and a few months. And you know, that's quite old for a doggy like that. She had a very active life. Let's see, where is she? Ah, over there. A very active life, but now she's old, you can see. She has a bit of arthritis, her rear legs. They look a bit wobbly. She's still doing okay, but we have to take our time. It's an Australian cattle dog. It's a pedigree. We got her from a dog breeder in Belgium. And he stopped breeding his doggies, so we didn't have to pay too much for her. She was happy. She was 12 weeks when we got her. And when those doggies are young, they are white. They're born white. Look like little rats. I'll show you a photo. And when they grow up, they get their color. This one is not so colorful. Some doggies are more colorful than this one. It is black and a bit of orange. Sometimes they have spots and speckles, and there are a lot of varieties of this dog. They originate from Australia. There they are used to herd cows, cattle, like our border collies do with sheep, she does with cows or horses. She's fond of horses. When I came to the part of the province that I'm in now, we bought a little farmhouse that needed renovating and modernization. I took a year off from work and renovated that. And I had about 2,000 square meters, so we had room for a donkey and a horse and chickens and horses. And these doggies, they are really friends. She likes to, yeah, to chase them. The horse knows that she doesn't mean harm, but she was always chasing the horse. And the horse name was Gijs. And when I said, "Ooh, go get Gijs," she would go behind him and, yeah, and send him to me. She has one big hobby, and that's eating. And when she had enough exercise, it was not such a problem. But now, yeah, she's a little overweight. But it's the only thing that really interests her, besides sleeping and being with the boss, is eating. When we get home, you'll see she likes to eat. We called her Tipper. And the reason was, when she was a little puppy, she was like this, like a big rat. One of her ears, the tip of her ears, was bent. And then we decided to call her Tipper. When she grew up, that ear that stood up again, so it was no problem. But she had a lopsided ear, so Tipper. And now we walk once a day for about 30 minutes. That's more than enough for her. And we didn't want to put on a leash, but rather a harness. Hey, it's more comfortable. And you'll see when we get back that I can use the harness to help her up the stairs. Down the stairs, I can carry her up the stairs. I think she weighs about 27 kilograms. That's a lot. Oh, I see there is another doggy. She likes to bark at other dogs. A bit of insecurity, I think. Nothing happens, but she likes to do that. You'll see in a minute. Ah, oh, yeah, see. Hey. Yep, that's another doggy. It's also a big dog, see? Yeah. And there's a white dog. Yeah. It says police on your harness, but don't act like one. Hey? You can see her tongue sticking out of the side of her mouth. We had, I think 2 years ago, had to let the doggy doctor, the doggy dentist, remove one of her molars. But when you remove the molars, oh yeah, there's another doggy. When you remove one of the molars, the tongue tends to go that way, so. Yeah, it looks a bit funny. Hey, when your tongue stick out, yeah, I know. Yeah, oh ho ho. But they originate from Australia. There is a little bit of dingo in this dog. And the dingo is the native dog in Australia. And yeah, that makes it a very strong, healthy and sturdy dog. She's never ill. She's over 14, and besides some overweight, she's doing okay. Yeah. Hey? You can see the tongue. Hey, her tongue sticking out a little bit. Yeah, see? So, let's turn. Let me go this way. But this is a beautiful area next to the river. Terneuzen in my hometown is a town next to the river, and this is normally quiet and nice to walk, and I don't have to put her on the leash every time we see someone. It's only looking out for the bicycles, but there are no bicycles now, only some people jogging and walking. When I had my farmhouse at the peak of our doggy ownership, we had five doggies. I had schnauzers, German breed, the name it's in the name already. And they come in three varieties. You had the small one, a middle size, and a big one. I had all three of them. And the breeder where we got the schnauzers from gave us a doggy for free that he used for breeding, but he didn't breed more than three nests. So, because we bought the schnauzers at his, we bought the three doggies from him, he gave us that older dog. It was six to us, so we had five dogs. And as long as we had the farmhouse, it was no problem, because when we opened the back door, they would all race out, do their business, room enough. Now I have only one doggy left, and she still keeps eating, only less exercise, so that means she got a little overweight. Our vet also says put her on a diet, but I think we will have her only one more year, so I don't want to take her big hobby from her. We don't overfeed her, but bicycles are coming. So, that's a bit the disadvantage of this place. People from Belgium, they come here to ride their sports bikes because we have nice asphalt. It's all beautiful asphalt here. All the bicycle paths are nice and smooth. So they come here. It's only 30 minutes from the border with a bicycle, I think. So, and there in the distance, you can see them. And you can tour all the way from Terneuzen all the way to the Belgian border on nice asphalt bicycle paths. So you have to be careful with that and your doggy. But I don't want to put her on a leash. You cannot walk your dog on leash. You can let her do her business, but she needs to sniff all the smells. Oh, look at your tongue. Look at your tongue. She needs to take in her all the smells and all the other doggies that are walking here. That's important for a dog. Don't walk your dog on leash only. It's not enough for them. They need to be off leash. So it's handy when your dog listens to you. So a bit of education is important. Cool, let's look at the side. Yeah. Sometimes I think, does she like her walks? But when I skip a walk at home, she's restless. She wants to have a walk. But when I see her walk, I think, oh my God, isn't she in pain? When you have a little arthritis, humans always complain about pain in the hips and in the knees, but doggies are not complaining easily. When a dog shows that he has pain, then he really has pain. So I think she is quite comfortable. I'd like to think so. Hey, Tipper? Yeah. But we enjoy her as long as we have her. It's a dog without problems. She barks sometimes, but she can be alone very well, no problem. She eats well, she sleeps. When we go out, we just tell her, give her a little doggy treat. She knows, the boss is going away. And it's really no problem. We have a camera at the house, a CCTV cam. And on my phone, I can check on her. I can hear what she's doing, and it's never a problem. It's a good doggy. We're back at the car. Let's see if we can get you in. I dropped the camera just now. Let's see if getting in the car is better, Opa, okay, now let's give you a boost. Opa. Goed zo. Oh, see how weak she is. Are you okay? I think so. Hé, Tipper? Ja. Hé, hey, it's hot. We'll start the car, get the ventilation going, and let's go home. Give us some food, change a drink, and I could use some coffee too. See you at home. Now, we've barked at everything. Let's go up the stairs. Let's go up the stairs. And that is where her little harness comes in handy. I can lift her. Oh, I hope you can see in the dark. There's more light. Okay. One, two, three. Hop. And I pull her up. So I take 5-6 kilos of her body. Hey, and then it's more easy for you. Opa. One more. Hop. See? And then we take it off. Hop. So. Let's see if we can get in. Let me see. Ah. There's my little friend doing his job. Let's hang up a little vacuum. Always when we go out, we let this little guy do his job. Let's stop him. Send him home. Oh yeah, there we go. There we go. Go home, little buddy. Hoppa! And he's charging again. What do you think, Tipper? We go eat? Get a can. Can food is here. Oop! Hoppa! So, I think I have to do some dishes today. With wifey at work, it's my job. Let's see. Let's put you guys on the counter. So I can open the can. Hoppa. Let's see. Get a spoon. It's about half a can she gets. The other half she will get later. So that's for later. Let's give her the food. So, and that's what she really likes to do. Eat. Eh? Lekker? Oh my. Your big hobby. We switch a little bit. Sometimes she gets canned food, like now. We also have the doggy cookies. These are doggy cookies. She likes them too. I can better ask, what does she not like? She likes, as long as it's food, she likes everything. She's a really easy dog. At least what food is concerned. Hey? Oh, but this is yummy. Because of the fact that her tongue sticks out on one side, it's a bit difficult for her to eat. It's okay now, but sometimes she spoils a lot. You know, we have a hard floor, so it's not really a problem. We can clean it. But she has... Oh, yeah. See, that's what I mean. She has a bit difficulty eating and getting the last pieces out of a bowl. And yeah, the vet says it has to do with missing a molar. And also the tongue on that side is a bit affected. It's like her tongue is paralyzed on one side. And she can eat, but...
Yeah, she makes a mess. You can see it's a bit dirty. Hey, but we will clean it up. We will clean it up later. Yeah, we will. You know what? I will hold the bowl for you. See? And it's a good doggy. She doesn't growl when you touch her bowl. We can take her food. Also handy when she eats something outside, something that you don't want her to eat. I can always take it from her. I know doggies that growl and that get really upset and angry when you touch their food. It's a normal reaction, but you cannot have that as a dog owner. You cannot have that. You must be able to take anything out of the mouth of your dog. Because when it's something poisonous or rotten, or they really like human poop. When a human did his business in the bushes and she smells it, she will eat it. And they can get really sick with that because of what we eat, I think. And you have to be able to, yeah, get her away from that, take it out of her mouth if necessary. Yeah. I used to say to my guests, if they didn't know better, when she finishes her bowl and she licks it out completely clean, or a plate, we just put it back in the cabinet. And that scared my visitors because they thought that I was being serious, that when she licks a plate clean, that we just put it back in the cabinet. But now, let's get some paper. Whoop. And let's clean up this a little bit here. And later we will do a mop. We mop the floor. You need to do that regularly with a dog like this. So, are we satisfied, my lady? Are we? Eh? Let's finish off with a doggy cookie. Come. Put this in the garbage. Get a doggy cookie. Doggy cookie. Can you sit? Go sit. Go sit. Go sit. Okay, and a doggy cookie. Now, the boss is going to make coffee. Probably go to sleep. No, not me, but you, the doggy, will probably go to sleep. Hey? Yup. And let's first make some coffee. Special cup, 2 layers. Keeps your coffee nice and warm. Let this thing heat up. I will get some milk. So, we put the milk here, and a little hose in the side, opa, hose and milk, and let's get you guys up. Let's see, I want it dark, I already touched that. Let's do a latte macchiato, that's a lot of milk and a little bit of coffee. Preheating, so we have to wait a little bit. But this is a handy machine. It can make coffee, tea, cappuccino, macchiato, cafe americano, espresso, doppio espresso. It's a handy thing. There he goes. Oh, meat first. Hey, Tipper? Yeah, you want more, I know. I know, I know, I know. Let's see. Fills it up nicely with milk. And then the coffee. It makes a bit of a noise. But then everybody knows, hey, they're making coffee. Let's see. You see, it's already nice and fluffy. I don't know if you can see it. But it foams up the milk. The bottom is milk, top is fluff. And there comes the coffee. Nothing? Yep. And that makes a beautiful, beautiful cup of coffee. What does he say? Your drink is ready. I can see.
See, this is a beautiful cup of coffee with milk froth on top. One of my favorites. Hey? You want to go on the balcony? I think so. The balcony is still nice and cool. This is one of our favorite places. Oh yeah, it's a lot of cool. It's a lot cooler than inside. You guys see our banana plants? They're 2 years old now. We bought them when they were oh so little. And I'm curious if they will get bananas. After 3 years it said they would give bananas. Edible bananas. And they are a dwarf kind of banana trees and gives a little bit of Filipino feeling. I like that. Hey? Yeah. Hey. Mm. Now you can do a little nap. The boss will drink his coffee. Hey? Later today we make fun again, okay? So let's enjoy our coffee. Mmm, this is really good. Ah, see you guys later. Maybe I will do a live vlog. I'm alone now. My first live I still have to do. Maybe I will do that. Time now is 9:41. Maybe 10:30? We'll see.
Yeah, that's better. That's better.
Yeah, welcome everybody. I see a lot.
Now, as you can hear. Already.
Sorry, I didn't announce this one. It just came up.
I just did my vlog. I am seeing how it is and put it on my YouTube channel. And the doggy is always where she's always at my feet, seeing what the boss does. She just was asleep, but now she's awake again. And she will go to sleep again. Oh, there we go. And this is what she will do for the next few hours, probably. So I'll see you again when she wakes up. Our doggy still sleeping. I will wake her up now. She needs a final walk for today. When we get back, she gets a little doggy treat, a fresh bowl of water, and then it's time to go to sleep for the night. Thanks for watching. If you like our videos, please subscribe. Hit the bell, the notification bell, so you will be notified when we upload a new video. Share, comment. Comments are always good. Thumbs up, thumbs down. It's your choice. Be safe. Ingat. And see you at the next vlog. Bye bye. You can say bye bye.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.
What the-